His whole intention is to start a little fire, a little bit of panic, and he will save the day. It's not quite going that way. To be the arsonist in this story is more than just being someone who's destructive. Henshaw has fallen in love with Katie.
This isn't gonna work. Sorry.
Henshaw's got two problems. He's got a woman who he adores who doesn't feel the same way as him. He's also got an ex, the shadow in the background. He's like a vulture on his like shoulder. He's like waiting just to step in there.
Well, you want to take a swing? Or do you want to hit her? Some more style in it?
I like you in a minute!
What happens in the fire is a metaphor, really, for Henshaw's life. He's honest. He loves this girl by stepping in and hopefully saving the woman he loves from a fire. She will look at him and go, you know, he is the one. But it goes out of control. And then people die.
Real snow, yes. Not fake. It's all real. Freezing.
The night when you filmed the fire, it was extreme because we'd had a few cancellations because of the snow. It's really cold. The crew were fantastic. Welcoming Sammy and Kelvin, it's been a real pleasure. I mean, Kelvin and I, we get down and dirty quite a few times, and it's going to be interesting to see those little frizzons.
It's now 20 past eight. We've been on since 4 o'clock, and if it does get any heavier than this, we will have to stop for the night. Just so that people can actually get home. We don't want the whole crew snowed into the village.
Okay, guys, it's a wrap. Everyone go home, please.
25 past eight and the snow is getting very heavy, and the forecast is that it's going to keep snowing until midnight, so we've had to wrap for the day, and we'll come back tomorrow and pick it up there.
Good night.
I think what you're going to see of Henshaw with later episodes is Andy's conflict. So you're going to see a finale to that conflict between the two men, and it gets nasty. We'll be right back.